What's up, guys? Nathan here, and today I want to talk about, do I recommend starting poker right now? You know, many years after the game became popular in sort of the mid-00s, if you guys are unfamiliar, it was around 2003 when poker sort of take off. It's what we call the poker boom, specifically between the years around 2003 to 2010. There was many different variables at play during that time. There was a young accountant from Tennessee named Chris Moneymaker, who won the 2003 World Series of Poker, I think, with a $6 tournament satellite online, and he ended up winning $2.5 million as an amateur poker player. Became sort of the dream of every guy in America, Europe, all over the world, really. Poker was also blowing up on the internet at this time. It was also really becoming popular on TV. That probably was actually more important than anything, with the introduction of hole cards and the World Poker Tour and stuff on TV. So there was a huge amount of interest in the game. Celebrities were all over poker. You know, there was basically a ton of dead money, what we call easy money in poker, with a lot of people that really, you know, weren't really that good, didn't really know what they're doing, but they had a lot of money to play poker with. Now, obviously, fast forward to today and things are a lot different. People, you know, there's a ton more poker training available, poker books. I mean, I've written three of them myself, videos like this. I've made hundreds of videos like this on YouTube and on other training sites in the past that basically give people the keys to, you know, at least play decent poker, you know? So really the question I want to get to in this video is should you as a beginner get into the game today? Is there decent prospects? Those are the questions that I'm going to answer. So let's just start with the most obvious one first. Can you make a lot of money playing poker these days? Well, guys, we kind of have to lower the bar. Like I said, this is not the poker golden era anymore where people have no clue what they're doing and are throwing money around. No, you're not going to become a millionaire overnight these days playing poker. In fact, the real reality of the situation is that most people do end up losing at poker in the long run, and it's only a very, very small percentage, especially these days, who are ever going to make significant money playing poker. And by significant, I'll just say, like, you know, $100,000 or more a year, or maybe $1 million lifetime earnings. It was more than just a hobby. It's something that actually made a down payment on a house or something, or gave them a semi-pro career, or even a full-time career in this game. I would say it's only going to be, you know, maybe 2% of all people who play poker that are ever going to achieve that level of success. Now, there's probably another 20% or so that do make a small profit playing poker as a hobby on the side. But for the vast majority of people, this will be a break-even or not so profitable hobby for them over the long run. Now, the thing is, though, is that we need to remember that poker is a card game. You know, it's a game that's meant to be played for fun. In fact, the vast majority of people who play poker, at least online, actually still play for nothing. They play for the fake chips that literally every single online poker site offers. A lot of people forget that it's usually like 80 or 90% of all people that are logged on the site that are actually playing for play money. They're not playing for real money. So the vast majority of people who play the game don't even play for a monetary goal in mind. They just play for the love of the game. Of course, there's tons of people that play, you know, the Friday night home game with the, you know, $10 buy-in and the beers with friends. There's nothing wrong with that because it's not really an amount that means anything to anyone. If you, you know, win the whole pot for the night, it pays for the beer or whatever, right? So the question here is, should you start playing poker right now? I mean, I would say, yeah, of course, why not? If you're playing number one for the fun and the thrill of the game, which is, you know, why you should be playing to begin with, as I always mention, you know, if you do have serious ambitions in the game, this is actually what's going to get you there in the long run, is your love and passion for the game. So if that's the place you're coming from, absolutely you should play poker these days. If you're coming to this game for a get-rich-quick scheme, I would say no, poker's probably not for you. You know, there probably are better ways to make money these days if that's your intention, but I would say that if you're looking for a get-rich-quick scheme in general, probably it doesn't matter what you choose, you're not going to be successful, because usually get-rich-quick schemes, as we know, are just a lot of hot air. Real success in anything, just like poker, takes a lot of blood, sweat, tears, dedication, and wading through a lot of deep, difficult waters. You know, I've been there myself as a longtime poker pro. There were countless times where I was ready to quit the game completely. I was assured that I would never win again. You know, this is one of the biggest challenges that this game brings you. But I was able to always pull myself back because of my deep love, passion, and appreciation for this game that has allowed me to live the life that I want, to travel the world. I've talked about how I've lived out here in Southeast Asia for nearly 10 years now, you know, and I haven't had to work a quote-unquote real job in since 2007 when I last quit. So this game has brought a lot of opportunities for me. It's changed my life in positive directions, but I still play this game for the same reason that you are getting into poker right now, and that's for the love of the game. I don't win every single day. Nobody wins every single day. If anyone tells you that, they're definitely full of hot air. All right, so if you're still with me here and you've decided to take poker seriously, well, okay, so where should you start? What is the best way to get you having some consistent success in this game? Well, I think you're gonna have to put in more effort these days to improving your skill level away from the tables. Perhaps this is not something you had to do, you know, maybe 15 years ago, you could just wait for your pocket aces and wait for some goofball to go all in with his 10 deuce offsuit, but that's not really the case these days. You're going to have to learn, number one, a solid fundamental ABC system, which basically is a sort of long-winded way of saying understanding what hands to play from each seat at the poker table, understanding how position works in poker, understanding how aggression works in poker, understanding when to bet, raise, bluff, fold, all of that kind of good stuff, the basic mechanics of the game, bet sizing, and all that stuff. For all of that, I would highly recommend just checking out my free poker cheat sheet. It's like 50 pages long. It's completely free. I'll put a link in the description below. It's going to give you a basic foundation on which to start winning in small stakes games without any cost to you. Beyond that, once you start moving up the limits and start facing much better opponents and professional poker players in some ways, you're definitely going to have to start studying some more advanced theory. In that case, there's a lot of great poker books out there these days. There's poker training courses. You can even hire a coach. If you guys are just starting out in the game, I would not go too off the deep end with this kind of stuff. I should mention there's also solvers and GTO type strategy, but I really think that you guys should focus mostly just on the basics, especially if you're playing at the lowest stakes, just starting out, whether that's cash games, tournaments, or sit and goes, or whatever game you decide to play. But once you start moving up the stakes a little bit, you're going to want to start learning some more advanced strategy. Once again, I'll leave a bunch of links in the description below for some of my top recommendations for that. Lastly, I'll just mention, like I just discussed, what games should you actually play in these days? What games are the most profitable? Well, you know, I think that this is a question that I get asked a lot. And honestly, I think that most games are profitable these days, some maybe a little bit more than others. But the thing is, like, I would say that number one, I would highly suggest specializing in one specific type of game. For example, if you want to play 6-max cash, just play 6-max cash. If you want to be the best stud 8 or better player, you know, just focus on learning stud 8 or better. Basically, what I'm saying is be a specialist, don't be a generalist. Don't try to play every single game and be the best at tournaments, be the best at cash games, be the best at pot limit Omaha, stud, all these kind of games. Just pick one and specialize, because like I said, you know, the games are not as easy these days. And so somebody who is a specialist, who understands one game on a much deeper level than most people, is probably going to have more success. I will say that No Limit Hold'em has been the most popular poker game for a long time now. That would be Texas Hold'em specifically, of the No Limit variety, which allows you to bet any amount that you want at any time. So I will say that No Limit Texas Hold'em is going to be where you're going to find the stiffest competition. So another sort of tip that I have for you is maybe look into some of the games, you know, that I just mentioned, you know, perhaps Pot Limit Omaha, a stud game, some of the draw games that, you know, people don't play as much. And the reason why you might have some more success in these games is because people don't focus on them so much. The level of play is not as high. There's not nearly as many like books and training courses and coaches. Like I mentioned before, it can be easier for you to gain some success in these games quickly. Now, with that said, of course, there's way more opportunities to play No Limit Hold'em, which is why I typically tend to just stick to that, because game selection is important, especially if you're a live poker player. You're going to be able to find a no limit hold'em game running almost all the time. But you know, if you're looking to play stud high low or something like that, unfortunately you might be out of luck. And if you can't play poker, then you're not going to make any money playing poker, obviously. So there's kind of pros and cons to each. But my number one thing is I would really recommend specializing in one specific format, you know, whether that's tournaments, sit and goes, cash games. And I would also pick a specific type of game as well, whether that's Texas Hold'em, whether that no limit or limit, pot limit Omaha, again, all sorts of games like this. Really, actually, what I would do is I would just, if you're brand new to the game of poker, just online or in the casino, and just play, you know, super low stakes and try playing each game and really just find out which game you enjoy the most. That's really the most important thing. Like I said, the whole point of poker is to enjoy the game. It's a game. We're meant to have fun. That's going to get you through the rough times in this game as well. So anyways, I hope that a couple of these thoughts help some of you guys that are asking yourself, should you start playing poker these days? Is it profitable? Is it going to be worth my time? Honestly, guys, you know, if you're here to get rich, no, don't. Like, I would not suggest playing poker, starting poker these days, if your goal is to get rich, because it's probably not going to happen for you. Can you make a decent side income or even a full-time income these days? Well, yeah, you can. I'm living proof that you can do it. You know, this game is going to be all-encompassing in many ways. You know, when I was first starting out in poker, this is literally all I did for years. And honestly, it's still the vast majority of my life, this game in some capacity to this day. But the bottom line, guys, you're probably watching this video because you just enjoy the game of poker. That's what got us all into this game in the first place. So if you want to play poker because you love the game, then absolutely, just go ahead. Not everything in life needs to be like, what's in it for me? What's in it for this? I mean, we go and watch movies not with an expectation of making money, right? We go watch a movie because we enjoy that actor. We enjoy films like, you know, a certain type of film like Fast and the Furious or something like that, right? It's ultimately up to you if you want to start poker right now these days. But I hope this video helped you guys sort of understand, give you kind of a rational, objective, down-to-earth kind of approach of what to expect these days. Anyways, if you have decided that you want to take poker as a serious pursuit, then make sure you subscribe to the channel here, because I'm putting out new strategy videos all the time to help you out. And also make sure you shovel in on that like button below if you found this video helpful. Lastly, make sure you grab a copy of my free poker cheat sheet. That'll be the top link in the description below, because that'll give you my strategy to get you started and confidently winning in small stakes games. Lastly, I'll leave a video I made recently here that I think will help you guys out some more. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. I'll catch you in the next one. This has been Nathan Williams with BlackRain79.com.